Now, last stage of sexual response cycle is regulation. Regulation means man is not able to have multiple orgasms immediately after the ejaculation. Man enters a refractory period, during which further orgasm or ejaculation is impossible. Usually the erection subsides quickly. There is a great variability in the duration of the refractory period. It may last from few minutes to many hours. This interval gets longer with each repeated ejaculation. As the man gets older, the refractory period gets longer. The period of return to the unaroused state is called the regulation phase. The anatomical and physiological changes that occur during the excitement and the plateau phase reverse. The blood is pumped out of the penis and therefore loss of erection. The testes decrease in size and descend in the scrotum. In women have physical capability of being multi-orgasmic, that is, they can have one or more additional orgasm within a short time, provided she receive continued effective sexual stimulation. Multiple orgasm seems to occur during masturbation than during the intercourse. Woman has no refractory period. The anatomical and physiological changes that occur during the excitement and the plateau phase reverse. The orgasmic platform disappears. As the blood is pumped away from this tissue, the uterus moves back into the resting phase. The vagina begins to shorten in both the width and length. Clitoris returns to its usual size and position. The breast decrease in size and areola flatter. Man and woman both return to the aroused state. Sex flush disappear and sweating is noticed. Heavy breathing and fast heartbeat receded gradually as the entire body relaxes. If orgasm has not occurred, resolution takes longer time. Lingering sensation of the pelvic heaviness is due to the vasocongestion, testicular aching in men and pelvic congestion in women may be relieved by orgasm that occurs by masturbation or during sleep. Men experience orgasm and nocturnal emission, wet dreams during sleep. Women also experience orgasm in sleep but no emission. There is considerable loss of sensory capacity which begin immediately upon the onset of sexual stimulation and which become complete during the maximum of sexual arousal and orgasm. At orgasm, some individual may remain unconscious for a few seconds. The attention of the individual may be so centered on sexual activities that he is not consciously aware of other sensory stimulation. There is anesthesia of the sensory structures. There are several myths about sexual response. For that purpose, this sexual response cycle is explained in details and male and woman. Thank you.